Hey everyone, Travis Thom with Elevated Real Estate Marketing here. I've got a few questions and a few different messages over the past couple weeks that I thought I would address for you guys. And one of them kind of goes into seeing other people's advertising and seeing other agents advertising in your market. And when you're scrolling through Facebook, you start to see their ads and you start to see some of what they're doing with their marketing, and it can feel that your market might be saturated, right? You get that feeling, well, if they're doing that, then all the homeowners, all the home buyers must be seeing that as well. And the truth of the matter is, they probably aren't. If you're seeing those ads, if you as a real estate agent are seeing other real estate agents' ads, it's bad targeting. If they're running ads and you're seeing them and you're not in the market and you're not positioning yourself to sell your home soon, well, really it just kind of equals to that they are not targeting the prospects properly. Now, what that does for you can be, it can be one of those kind of overwhelming experiences where you decide to just kind of give up because you think that your market is saturated with different types of ads, but really it's just the opposite. If you're seeing those ads, once again, the targeting is not right. And you shouldn't take that as a threat or some sort of message that you shouldn't run ads because you feel like it's overly saturated. There's thousands and millions of different ads that are being run on an hour-by-hour basis inside of Facebook. Now, Facebook determines exactly who's gonna see those ads based on the ad targeting. So if anyone and everyone in your market is kinda seeing some of these, well, then they're really not laser focused on the actual life stage of that individual, that homeowner that's getting their house ready to sell, or that home buyer that just wants to see a list of homes. You are a real estate agent, or you're a mortgage broker, or a title officer, whatever it might be, and if you're seeing those ads, I wouldn't get discouraged. I would get motivated. I would actually see that there's a bigger opportunity here. Now, if you think to what that strategy should be, well, you need to be able to really laser focus in on exactly those prospects, exactly the ones that are entering into a certain life stage where they need to sell. And a good majority of those people are homeowners, right? Homeowners are also buyers. They need to sell in order to buy something, typically. And if you think, probably about 53% of all the homeowners that own the majority of all the real estate in the nation, in the United States, if you're watching this in the US, are baby boomers, right? People that are over 63 years old, that are empty nesters, and they're typically living in a little bit of a larger home and they need to downsize. So they are controlling a massive amount of the real estate market. That is a perfect opportunity for you to market to them. So just kind of take a few of those statistics and really start to map out essentially what your targeting should look like. So I would go after baby boomers, people that are over the age of 63 years old, that own a home, and that are empty nesters, and you can kind of layer in some other interests. Maybe they're interested in buying a home. They've looked at Zillow or Realtor.com or Trulia or Homes.com or Redfin. They may have downloaded some of those apps. These are all different targeting interests that you can utilize right now and run ads specifically to homeowners. And maybe you might have an ad that might say something along the lines of, see all the homes that are one story. Right, or see all the homes that are only 1,500 square feet, or see all the homes that are below 2,000 square feet starting at 385,000. I mean, every market's gonna be different in terms of pricing and square footage, but just know that most homeowners that are baby boomers are entering into that next life stage of wanting to downsize. So when you look in your newsfeed and you see people offering home valuations or different things like that, don't get discouraged. It's not market saturation, it's just bad targeting. So refine your strategy. See that as an opportunity to laser focus on the niches so you can really get the biggest results.